The first time you open PI ProcessBook, you're met with all of the program's default settings. The default homepage will pop up, and all of your toolbars will have a default look to them. And when you go to build a display, your display and all the symbols on it will take on a default look until you change their colors and sizes manually. In this video, we'll be making changes to our PI ProcessBook settings and defaults so that whether we're building new displays or connecting to a PI data archive to use a display that's already been made for us, our defaults should reflect how we're likely to use PI ProcessBook and ultimately save us time down the road. The first thing we can do is set the default connection to the PI data archive. When PI ProcessBook or a previous program that uses the PI SDK is installing, it'll ask you to specify a PI data archive to connect to, and that will remain your default until you change it. In order to change it, here in File, Connections, we're met with a list of PI data archives that the machine knows about. The ones we're connected to will be indicated by a check mark, and if we want to change the default connection, here in Tools Options, we can use the pull-down menu in the default server settings. Since I'm interested in leaving it at LRN PySRV, I'll click OK and then Close. Next up, we'll decide the default PyAF server and PyAF database to connect to. Here in File, PySystems, we're met with the Select Database window where we can see the database of our default PyAF server. If we want to change or add a PyAF server to connect to, we can show this list and right-click and add an asset server. The asset servers we're currently connected to are indicated by these green dots, and the default PyAF server is indicated by this black check mark. If I wanted to change the default, I could right-click and set a different default AF server. Since I'm interested in letting the LRN PySRV2 remain my default, I'll close. And here I can see that this database is my default AF database as indicated by this black check mark. Since this is also what I want, I'll simply close this window as well. Next, I'll set the layout of my toolbars to make them look how I want them to. Toolbars can simply be dragged and dropped by clicking on these handles and letting them go where you want them to be. You can also show and hide toolbars here in the View Toolbar menu, where we can select or unselect and have the toolbars hide and appear immediately. So if I'm no longer interested in seeing my layout toolbar, simply clicking Layout will hide that for me. Next, we'll set our Tools Preferences. This menu will have some options that will dictate how PI ProcessBook will behave in general, and it'll have some tabs that will decide the defaults that PI ProcessBook will use to create new displays and symbols. Here in the General tab, these are all options that will decide how PI ProcessBook behaves in general. So for instance, here's the startup file that will open every time PI ProcessBook does. We can change this by browsing to a different PDI or PIW file and clicking Open. Another option of note on this page is the Prefer Run Mode checkbox. While Prefer Run Mode is checked, anytime you finish building a symbol in build mode, you'll automatically return to run mode. Additionally, anytime you open up PI ProcessBook, you'll also find yourself in run mode. If you plan on building a lot of symbols or displays back to back, I'd recommend taking run mode off. But if you're intending to just consume displays, preferring run mode is ideal. Next, we can set our date and time formats. So this will decide how our timestamps look and whether they show subseconds or not. And we can choose to see the events as they're appeared on the client machine's time zone or the PI server or PI data archive's time zone. This is only really useful distinction when your PI data archive and client machine are in different time zones. If you want to know what some of these other options do, in our PI Live library, you can search for the preference settings in the PI ProcessBook 2015 library. Here we can see the exact technical details of every checkmark in this menu. Next, we'll talk about our Table of Contents tab. This tab will decide how PI ProcessBook will display PI ProcessBook book files, or PIW files. We can define how each entry level will look within PI ProcessBook. So if we want our level 1 entries, that are our titles, to be bigger than our level 2 entries, we can simply click level 1, make them size 16, and then applying will update the look instantly. This is because this page will decide how PI ProcessBook will display the book files. Next, we'll talk about our display window, our trend, and our trend elements. This tab will decide all the defaults of your displays and the symbols that you create on those displays. For instance, this display was made with the defaults with a gray background. It's got white lines and text, and fill colors, I'm using blue. If I was to change my background to white, lines to black, I'll change my fill color to green, and then remove the symbol background color, and then change the font to something like Impact. Clicking Apply won't actually affect any display that already exists. That's because this display window will only set the defaults of any symbols or displays that I create new. The same is true for my Trend and my Trend Elements tab, which look a lot like the Define Trend tab when you double-click on a trend in build mode. For instance, if I don't want to see a legend by default, but I do want to see markers, and instead of an 8-hour time by default, I want to see a 7-day time, I can set that here. Clicking Apply again won't actually change the trends that exist until I create a new trend. Of course, the same is true for my trend elements, so I can switch my color to blue and my marker type to boxes, and likewise, hitting OK, the trend won't actually change. Now here in File New, I can make a new ProcessBook display, and immediately we can see that it's using the new background color, which I defined as white. Now when I make a bar graph, we can see our bar graphs are now using the green color by default instead of blue, and they have the black background and the impact text instead of the white background and the aerial text. Similarly, our trends, we'll take the blue color by default, and now we can see that we're using the squares instead of the circles as our markers. And like always, we can go back to build mode and double-click on our symbols in order to change the definition away from default to something else. Another place we can define preferences is in the PI ProcBook ini file. Here we can set some of our more advanced settings and definitions, so I'll recommend using our PyLive library and search for the ProcBook ini section within the PI ProcessBook 2015 page in order to understand some of our more complex options that this file has the power to change. So far in this video, we set our default PI data archive, PI AF server, and then some of our preferences and the default style of all of our symbols and book entries. By making these changes to my installation of PI ProcessBook, I'll be able to make more consistent looking displays, as well as save time by removing the need to change the look and feel of my displays and symbols over and over again.